is, can we have order that is emergent rather than imposed so that we aren't stuck with chaos and infighting and inability to coordinate, and we're also not stuck with oppression? And what would it take to have emergent order? This is the most kind of central question for me these days, because if we look at what different nation states are doing around the world, and we see nation states that are more authoritarian, that in some ways are actually coordinating much more effectively. So, for instance, we can see that China has built high-speed rail not just through its country, but around the world, and the U.S. hasn't built any high-speed rail yet. You can see that it brought 300 million people out of poverty in a time where we've had increasing economic inequality happening. You can see, like, that if there was a single country that could make all of its own stuff, if the global supply chains failed, China would be the closest one to being able to start to go closed loop on fundamental things. Belt and Road Initiative, supply chain on rare earth metals, transistor manufacturing, that is like, oh, they're actually coordinating more effectively in some important ways in the last, call it, 30 years. And
that's imposed order.
Imposed order. And we can see that if in the U.S., if now let's look at why real quick. We know why we created term limits, so that we wouldn't have forever monarchs. That's the thing we were trying to get away from, and that there would be checks and balances on power and that kind of thing. But that also has created a negative second order effect, which is nobody does long-term planning. Because somebody comes in who's got 4 years, they want reelected. They don't do anything that doesn't create a return within 4 years that will end up getting them elected, reelected. And so the 30-year industrial development to build high-speed trains or the new kind of fusion energy or whatever it is just doesn't get invested in. And then if you have left versus right, where whatever someone does for 4 years, then the other guy gets in and undoes it for 4 years. And most of the energy goes into campaigning against each other. This system is just dissipating as heat, right? Like, it's just burning up as heat. And the system that has no term limits and no internal friction in fighting because they got rid of those people can actually coordinate better. Is we want a kind of order at various scales, from the conflicting parts of ourself actually having more harmony than they might have, to family, extended family, local, all the way up to global. We want emergent order where our choices have more alignment, right? We want that to be emergent rather than imposed, or rather than we want fundamentally different things or make totally different sense of the world where warfare of some kind becomes the only solution. Emergent order requires us, in our choice making, requires us being able to have related sense-making and related meaning-making processes. Can we apply digital technologies and exponential tech in general to try to increase the capacity to do that, where the technology called a town hall, the social tech that we'd all get together and talk, obviously is very scale-limited, and it's also oriented to geography rather than networks of aligned interest? Can we build new, better versions of those types of things? And going back to the idea that a democracy or participatory governance depends upon comprehensive education in the science of government, which includes being able to understand things like asymmetric information warfare on the side of governments and how the people can organize adequately. Can you utilize some of the technologies now to be able to support increased comprehensive education of the people and maybe comprehensive informedness? So both fixing the decay in both education and the fourth estate that have happened, so that people can start self-organizing to then influence the corporations, the nation states, to do different things and or build new ones themselves. Yeah, fundamentally, that's the thing that has to happen. So we basically need new problem-solving processes that do better at being able to internalize externality, solve the problems on the right time scale and the right geographic scale. And those new processes, to not be imposed, have to emerge from people wanting them and being able to participate in their development, which is what I would call kind of a new cultural enlightenment or renaissance that has to happen, where people start understanding the new power that exponential tech offers, the way that it is actually damaging current governance structures that we care about, and creating an X-risk landscape, but could also be redirected towards more protopic purposes. And then saying, how do we rebuild new social institutions? What are adequate social institutions where we can do participatory governance at scale and time? And how can the people actually participate to build those things? The solution that I see working requires a process like that.
If you want to see a new and better world come to fruition, as I do, then like, share, and subscribe. You can find an incredible amount of math, knowledge, and 3D renders by clicking on the channel name. And remember, we need you to help spread this vision across the internet for all to see and become familiar with. Let us build this new world together.